Do you see the screen?
Yeah, it's okay. So the next speaker is Dr. Hayata Yamasaki from Vienna. So he's going to talk about polylogs, overhead high default tolerance measurement based quantum computation, application of entanglement with a geometric constraint. Please start.
Hello, I am Hayata Yamasaki. I was previously working in the University of Tokyo and now working at IQQ Vienna in Austria. Thank you for thank you very much for organizing such a nice workshop and giving me an opportunity to talk about our recent work, application of entanglement without geometrical constraints, especially in measurement-based quantum computation. This is a joint work with Kui-san and Kui-san in University of Tokyo, Takeuchi-san, Tani-san at NTT, and Kawai-san also in the University of Tokyo. So I'll begin with explaining a background. So entanglement is a non-local property appearing in multipartite quantum systems on a composite system, a multipartite quantum state on a composite system. So in this talk, I write each subsystem as a circle and an entangled state as lines between circles. As shown in many other talks, entanglement nowadays plays important roles in analyzing many body quantum physics, such as ADS CFT and topologically ordered states and so on. On the other hand, entanglement is also crucial in implementing quantum computation, especially by means of measurement-based quantum computation, or MBQC for short. A main goal of this talk is to introduce our recent investigation of an interesting entanglement structure that is useful for implementing quantum computation at low overhead cost. So before going into measurement-based computation, I summarize the notion of quantum computation. Quantum computation is a model of computation using the law of quantum physics. And at the beginning of quantum computation, we initialize qubits in a fixed product basis. And then we perform some unitary time evolution to prepare some entangled state. Finally, we perform a measurement of these qubits to obtain some measurement outcome as an output of computation. The outcome is given with probability according to the square of the amplitude of the state given in the measurement basis. So in this way, we can solve some computational problems faster than conventional classical computation. So that's the motivation of considering quantum computation. And this can, so it is actually known that any unitary time evolution can be decomposed into a product of some set of unitary matrices on a few qubits. These unitary matrices are called quantum logic gate, and quantum algorithms are conventionally written as quantum circuits like this. So many gate sets are known to be useful for this decomposition. And one of the examples is 1-qubit Adamard gate and 3-qubit controlled Z gate, which is relevant to this talk. The cost of implementing quantum computation is quantified by required number of gates in the circuit. This is because to perform unitary time evolution, we apply the gates in the circuit one by one, and the number of gates provides some cost. Next, I explain MBQC, measurement-based quantum computation. Measurement-based quantum computation is a model of quantum computation that combines preparation of some entangled state and measurement of this state to implement the quantum computation. In MBQC, we first prepare a fixed entangled state that is independent of what to compute. This entangled state is called a resource state for MBQC. Many resource states are known to be useful for MBQC. For example, we may use graph states on some 2D or 3D lattices, or even some ground states on some 2D local Hamiltonians, such as AKLT states and many other states that have particular symmetry. In particular, a graph state is a multi-qubit entangled state represented as a graph like this, which is obtained by preparing some, some single qubit plus state at each vertex, and then apply two qubit controlled Z gate for each pair of qubits connected by an edge. Given this kind of resource states, we perform measurements on each qubit to conduct quantum computation as desired. Each single qubit measurement may transform the state randomly, but conditioned on previous measurement outcomes, we adaptively choose the measurement basis so that we can implement a desired unitary time evolution in the end, where we use the local interaction of the resource state as an entangling gate to implement this unitary. So indeed, measurement-based quantum computation is not just a theoretical model, but in this talk, I would like to introduce a recent technological development for indeed realizing MBQC using photonic systems. So I believe this is one of the most important promising candidates for implementing quantum computation in a scalable way. This approach uses photonic systems, and in this approach, light sources continuously emit light, and shifting the timing by optical delay line, such as optical fiber, we use different time domain of the light as subsystems to be entangled. And the entangled resource state for MBQC is independent of what to compute, and hence can be generated only by a fixed optical circuit in a scalable way. In MBQC, we switch measurement basis performed by optical detector to conduct quantum computation. And a remarkable point is that large-scale entanglement over millions of subsystems have been demonstrated in recent experiments in this setting. And also, the switching between measurement basis for performing MBQC is very fast, can be implemented very fast, even under current technologies. These technologies can realize entanglement even without geometrical constraints, since flying photonic systems can be freely moved in space. And this kind of freely moving in space is actually crucial for achieving low overhead in implementing quantum computation, as I will explain in the next slide as well. A technical difficulty in the implementation may arise from introducing non-Gaussianity in preparing the photonic resource state. Therefore, this architecture may require some completely different designing principle from matter-based implementation of quantum computation, such as superconducting qubits. And this technological progress is one of the motivations for our investigation of new entanglement structure suitable for this setting, for this kind of setting without geometrical constraints. Actually, in quantum computation, what to compute is conventionally given via some circuit that may include non-local gate acting on arbitrary pairs of qubits. But actual implementation of the circuit usually causes some overhead cost. Here I show some example. For example, if we implement some quantum computation using n superconducting qubit aligned on two-dimensional chip surface like this, then the constraint on local interactions between qubits on the 2D surface causes polynomially large overhead. In this case, in particular, the in this case, implementation of each geometrically non-local gate requires some quadratically large overhead to mediate the long-range interaction only by local interactions. This kind of polynomial overhead totally or partially cancels out useful speedups of quantum computation, especially useful some useful polynomial quantum speedups, as I will discuss later. And a similar overhead also arises in existing MBQC protocols that uses resources generated within some geometrical constraints. For example, consider the graph state generated on this kind of two-dimensional square lattice. This is called cluster state. To implement geometrically non-local gates like this, we need to use multiple local interactions like this and this. We need to use multiple local interactions for implementing each gate. So we cannot avoid polynomial overhead to mediate the long-range interactions. As long as we use such geometrical constrained resource state. The question we ask here is whether we can construct a better entanglement structure for reducing this kind of overhead. So here I summarize the results. In contrast to existing MBQC protocols with polynomial overhead, we construct a protocol for photonic MBQC that achieves polylogarithmic overhead in implementing quantum circuits that may include geometrically non-local gates. To achieve this, we introduce a new entanglement structure that is useful for implementing low overhead qubit permutation. And also our protocol is optimized for photonic architectures in that it is implementable by some measurements that are relatively easy to perform. Furthermore, based on this protocol, our paper also shows a highly fortunate protocol for photonic quantum computation. But so in this talk, I do not explain full details of how to attain this kind of fortunance, but the basic idea is to suppress noise using quantum error correcting codes. In particular, in a proposal, we use the so-called GKP code to encode qubit into infinite dimensional system, such as light. And we concatenate it with 7-qubit code for quantum error correction at the qubit level. This result opened a new way towards realizing a large class of quantum speedups, including those polynomial. So I proceed to introduce our result on polylog overhead MBQC. In MBQC, we use some resource state with some fixed entanglement structure, which is independent of the compute. So we need to implement each gate within this entanglement structure. So given some quantum circuit to be implemented, what we actually perform in MBQC is an equivalent circuit respecting the entanglement structure in MBQC. In our protocol, quantum computation is represented as an arbitrary n qubit d depth quantum circuit composed of a computationally universal gate set H and CCZ. So using this gate set, any circuit composed of Clifford and T gates can be written using H and CCZ up to polylogarithmic overhead. In MBQC, so here let T denote the number of required gates for implementing the whole MBQC protocol to simulate this circuit. Here the complexity of MBQC includes preparation of the resource state, implementation of measurements, and feed-forward classical processing for deciding measurement basis adaptively. The overhead here refers to T divided by Dn, where Dn is the maximum possible number of gates in the original circuit. So to achieve polylog overhead, we bound this by some polylogarithmic function. The MBQC protocol that we are proposing is optimized based on the designing principle for photonic MBQC. Our resource state for MBQC is a hypergraph state, which is and so this hypergraph state is a generalization of a graph state. In particular, hypergraph state is a multi-qubit entangled state that can be obtained by preparing plus state for each vertex and applying controlled Z gate for each edge, similarly to graph states. But additionally, by applying controlled Z gate for each hyper edge over three vertices. Although our resource state looked a bit complicated at the first sight, this actually has some periodic structure. So we can generate this state by reusing some fixed single optical circuit many times. So what I have shown is that this entanglement structure achieves polylog overhead. And this is a new perspective in MBQC, since conventional resource states for MBQC are designed to be generated within some 2D or 3D geometrical constraints, and hence causes polynomial overhead. Furthermore, a resource state can implement universal quantum computation only by measurements in X and Z bases. This means that even if we use quantum error correcting codes to attain full tolerance, we do not need on-demand magic states for implementing some costly measurements in non-Pauli bases, as long as we can prepare this fixed entangled state. A drawback in implementation may be that this resource state cannot be generated within two-dimensional constraints. But this does not matter so much since photonic qubits can be easily moved in space. Instead, our resource state is designed to save some non-Gaussianity. If we use the GKP code as an error correcting code, each qubit in this resource state becomes a non-Gaussian state that is costly to generate in photonic experiments. So given this situation, we save the number of qubits from polynomial to polylogarithmic to save this cost. So here I roughly sketch the idea of low overhead, the main idea of this entangled state. So one of our significant contributions is to construct the entanglement structure that is useful for reducing overhead in MBQC. In our implementation, we use each period of our resource state like this to implement Adamar and CCZ gates at one depth. But we can perform H and CCZ gate using this part of resource state only within this fixed entanglement structure. This part of entanglement structure by itself would not be sufficient for implementing geometrically non-local gates like this. To perform geometrically non-local CCZ gates, the former part can be used for implementing permutation of qubits in an arbitrary order. To achieve this, we introduce an idea of sorting networks to entanglement structure. A sorting network is a fixed circuit consisting of a comparator that works either swap or identity gates. And using this sorting network can rearrange input in arbitrary order to some desired order. A practical construction of sorting network with log square depth is known. So in our proposal, we use this sorting network in particular. We show that a graph state represented by this subgraph can be used for implementing either swap and can be used for implementing both swap and identity gates. and hence this can work as a comparator. Using this subgraph as parts, we obtain an entanglement structure for implementing the sorting network. In this way, we can overcome geometrical constraints only using a polylog number of qubits rather than polynomial. And I also remark that this idea of sorting network is also applicable in general, not only in this particular resource state. In our paper, what we have shown is this implementation, this can implement any n-qubit d-depth circuit at a polylog overhead cost, including preparation of resource state, and implementation of each measurement, and classical processing for deciding appropriate measurement basis in MBQC. At the end of the talk, I would like to discuss some outlooks in several aspects. Firstly, our results provide some insight on seeking interesting entanglement structure without geometrical constraints. Although it may be conventional in many body physics to consider entangled state on some fixed geometrical constraints. But actually, technologies for generating entanglement without geometrical constraints are now actually available. And based on this progress, our results show that there may also be a reasonable situation and so much room to arbitrarily design and optimize entanglement structure for MBQC and for other purposes as well. And this contributes to clarifying what we can experience in this world within the law of quantum mechanics if we make the most of the potential of entanglement without geometrical constraints. In my opinion, there's so much room for this kind of investigation. And secondly, so there are actually, apart from some super polynomial speed up of quantum algorithms, such as Schrodinger algorithm, quantum computation can also achieve useful polynomial speed ups in some problems, such as recommendation system and combinatorial optimization. Also, quantum algorithm for machine learning usually assumes a very extreme assumption on sparsity and low rank. And without these assumptions, in a large parameter region, such algorithms achieve polynomial speedups. So here I would like to briefly mention that our recent work discovers some application of exponential speedup in quantum machine learning without sparsity and low rank assumptions. So this may be some exception, but polynomial speedups are still useful for many applications of quantum computation. And our results are useful for realizing polynomial speedups without canceling out the speedups. So lastly, our results may also lead to some acceleration in wide range applications of MBQC. One of such examples may be blind quantum computation based on MBQC. And in this context, our results show that the overhead of implementing blind quantum computation by MBQC can be reduced to as small as polylogarithmic rather than polynomial. Again, so this is suitable for implementing polynomial speedups, such as quantum recommendation system in a blind way. So here's a summary of the talk again. So thank you very much for your attention. I'd be happy if you could reach me out for further discussions if you're interested. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. So question or comment, please.
Can I ask a question?
Yes, Polymer, please.
Thank you very much for interesting talk. So actually, I didn't understand what do you mean by entanglement structure. Is this just a graph of graph state?
In this talk, it means graph. Yeah, it means, underlying the graph and hypergraph corresponding to the resource state. So you say your
hypergraph resource state is useful because this requires only X and Z basis measurement. But because this is a hypergraph state, so you have to apply control Z gate to generate this resource state. And this operation is non-Clifford. So maybe this part is difficult for fault tolerant computation.
So In actual implementation, what we are proposing is that we decompose it into T gates and pre-fold gates. So we use 40 gates to implement CCZ gates. But in the actual costly part in Fortran photonic computation is preparation of each qubit. This is non-Gaussian. And the cost of preparing pari eigenbases such as zero state and magic state are comparable in our analysis. They have similar non-Gaussianity as long as they are encoded in GKP code. And so what is costly may depends on systems. And for photonic systems, so preparation of qubits and magic states are comparably costly. But once we have these things, maybe other things are Gaussian operations that are easier to implement. So CCZ gate may require 4 magic state, but anyway, other gates may require GKP qubits as well.
Thank you.
Okay, other question or comment? If not, it's okay. So okay, so let's thank the speaker again. Thank you very much. So we have a 20 minutes break. So the next talk will start from what time? So 11:15. Robert?
Yes, I am.
Could you share your screen to make sure?
Oh, okay, yeah, just a second. Let's see. So you see a picture of black holes in thermal equilibrium?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So. I'm going to stop sharing because I'm just flipping through it. I'm just practicing a little bit more.
Thank you very much for all. Yeah.
Oh, hi, Tadashi.
Hi, yeah. Good morning.
Good morning.
It's opposite.
No, I think you picked the times very well, actually. I've been joining in the evening and in the morning. It works very well. Yeah. Okay, I'm just going to look at my talk a little bit more, and then I'll join later.
Okay, see you later.